Endless rehearsing transformed this pose into his anchor. These triggers or anchors are not hard to create. It just takes practice. I've created a simple system for you to follow. The anchor method. A. Acceptance. The first step is accepting that you are experiencing some form of emotion that's causing a negative impact on your performance. In this example, we will use fear. For instance, if you are someone who has to give presentations to a group of colleagues or potential clients, you may experience self-doubt, a dry mouth, shaking, and even nausea. These are all symptoms that can affect how you deliver your presentation. Once you have accepted these feelings, recognizing that you can shape or change these emotions will allow you to start the process. N. New emotion. Decide what emotion you would prefer to feel in this situation in the future. What feeling would you like to swap for abject fear? What emotions would generate your best performance? Let's say you'd like to feel calm, confident, and in control. C. Call upon a previous scenario. Think back to a situation where you felt calm, confident, and in control. It could be a work-based scenario, or it could be from some other part of your life. Time spent with family or in a particular place that you find relaxing or calming. H. Hold on to that thought. This is where your visualization skills come into play. Picture that time or place as vividly as you can, focusing particularly on how you felt. Paint a picture in your mind. See it, hear it, and taste it. For this to be most effective, feel as though you have been transported there. Spend time noticing the effect this scene has on you and your body and mind. O. Overlay a stimulus. Now you need to apply a stimulus that you can use in any situation. Common triggers include touching the tip of your middle finger and thumb together, tapping your toe on the ground, or gently snapping an elastic band worn on your wrist. Ideally, you want something that would be almost imperceptible to any onlooker. If you are standing in front of an audience during a presentation, you don't want them to see you performing an overly flamboyant trigger. R. Repeat. If you repeat this action often enough, it becomes an anchor. In a highly stressful environment, performing the trigger should instantly shift your mind to your preferred emotion. The action anchors you to your desired emotion. You can perform the trigger before you stand up in front of an audience, and several times during the presentation, converting your fear to a feeling of being calm, confident, and in control.